countless different types of enrichment toys. Here are just a few. But realistically, you could make your own if you wanted to. An enrichment toy is just something that gets the dog to think critically while using multiple parts of their body. So we're looking to activate the sense of smell, the sense of sight, the sense of hearing. We're looking to activate all of their senses in order to accomplish this goal. So this particular enrichment toy is very interesting because it can adjust the difficulty levels. So this is Zira's first time utilizing it, so we have it as easy as possible. And one thing that we want to make sure when we are introducing the enrichment puzzles like this is that it's very easy for them to become chew toys. So we want to make sure that we are monitoring the dog while they're using it to ensure that they are utilizing it properly. So if you have a dog that has a problem with chewing or jumping or barking or destroying things, it's a very good chance that they do have a lot of pent-up energy, and these enrichment toys are what's going to help to alleviate some of that frustration within the dog. So what we're doing is we're harnessing these natural behaviors of sniffing and scavenging and problem solving and chewing, and we're using them to provide a very specific kind of mental and physical stimulation to the dog. And what you're gonna find is that when we offer mental stimulation to dogs, it's going to tire them out way faster than any sort of physical activity you could possibly do. 5 minutes of asking a dog to wait for something, you're gonna start to notice very quickly how they start panting, how they start exhibiting symptoms of physical exhaustion because they're having to have that immense amount of impulse control. And even if they're not problem behaviors that you're dealing with, maybe you just have a high energy dog, these enrichment toys are going to really help to calm them down mentally, so that then you can bring in the obedience training and the behavioral training, which will be far more effective now. Which brings us to a very interesting point, which is that we can actually use enrichment toys, not just with treats, but with actual food, with their meals, their daily meals, if you feed them once or twice or three times a day, however often you feed your dogs. If instead of using a regular food bowl, you use the enrichment toy, now you're gaining double those benefits. That can also be very helpful if you have a dog that's a fast eater. This will help to slow them down tremendously while also expending that mental energy, so that they start to actually slow down and think during feeding time instead of just ravaging the food. Then the third tip that I mentioned was how to most effectively utilize Kongs. Now we all know the Kong company, they make some of the best puppy and dog toys out there, but I'm talking about the traditional Kong. One thing that we want to make sure is that we're putting something freezable and malleable in there, like cheese or peanut butter, and then you can mix that with whatever you want to put in there, their food for the day, maybe some chicken, maybe some treats, but then you take it and you put it in the freezer. Leave it in there for a couple hours, and when you take it out, it's going to take them twice as long to be able to finish this thing. You will be amazed by how long it takes them to finish this thing, but they're gonna love it. They're gonna be so entranced by it. This is gonna be fantastic for storms or any situation where you really want them to be focused and occupied for a long period of time. It's also going to increase the difficulty of the basic call. So if you do have a high energy smart puppy who's already figured out how to utilize the Kong very, very easily and quickly, This is another option to, again, up that difficulty and make it last a little bit longer. So thanks for watching this video on enrichment toys. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please leave them in the comment section below. As always, don't forget to smash that like button. Don't forget to click that red subscribe button and join me on this journey of some minor dog training where I teach you how to train yourself to better train your dogs.